We've got our hands on Facebook's Portal TV. Let's open it and take a look. Let's get this bad boy unboxed. Let's find somewhere to cut into it. There we go. Very gently. Don't want to cut anything inside. There we go. Get that plastic off like so. Here we go. Right. Let's have a little look. So for those that don't know much about Portal, because it is new to the UK, I mean, it's been in the US for quite a while now, but those of us in the UK might not have heard of all this. It's essentially Facebook's way of opening up the world of video messaging, video calling, sorry. And this is the latest. Portal TV is the latest. You've got the Portal frames and stuff that have been available for quite some time in America. They're also in the UK now. But Portal TV is the latest. It's the new one. It's the exciting one. So let's have a little look. Okay, so it's smaller than I thought it was going to be, actually. Got this little camera unit here that sits on the top or on the bottom of your TV, depending on how you want it set up, but we'll come to that in a minute. So we've got the actual unit itself. Very nice. And then in the bottom, we've got a remote control, because obviously, unlike the tablet-based Portal devices, you can't actually tap anything because your TVs aren't touch-compatible. So, old-school remote, it is what it is. That's that. And then what else is in the box? So we've got, I assume, instructions. Yep, Facebook, yep. Okay, we don't need instructions. We don't need instructions. They can go there. And then, of course, we've got our power brick. Like so. So you might notice that there is something missing from that collection, and that is HDMI cable. It's absolutely crucial, obviously, to connect the Portal TV to your TV, but it doesn't come with one, so make sure you buy one separately or dig one out the drawer. Let's take a little look at this before we set it up. Let's take this plastic off, my favorite part of any unboxing. Oh yeah, there we go. Oh no, it's not quite as clean as other ones. Why isn't this coming off? I know. I don't know. I'm just gonna rip it off. There we go. So, not the most elegant of, you know, unwrappings, but there we are. So let's take a little look at the device itself. So as you can see at the front here, we've got our, let's take this off. Here we go, our camera. And for the, you know, for privacy focused amongst us, you can cover the camera at any time. And that, you know, obviously at that point, you can't, no one can hack in and watch you while you're watching TV or anything like that. On the top, you've got 8 microphones, so you can use the device handheld, hands-free, should I say, or you can use the microphone because there is also a microphone built into the remote here. So you can talk like that, or if the room's quiet enough, just shout. and then on the back, you've got a USB-C port along with a HDMI port and another port, which I have no idea what that's for. Well, that's fun. So this is the interesting part, because this is the little grip system that you'll be using to attach it to your TV. Now, depending on your setup, you might want to put it on the top of your TV, so it'll sit on the top like so, or you can angle it and put it on beneath your TV and kind of angle it up like that. It depends on your setup. But the only thing is, you want to make sure that wherever it's located, you want to move it away from your TV speakers, because it'll make it very hard to actually video call anyone. Right, so I think we're pretty much done with the unboxing side of things. Let's get this bad boy set up. So I'll just be putting this HDMI, obviously, into the back of the device itself, and then it sits on the TV like so. And then you can adjust the angle of the grip at the back so it sits at the angle that you want it to. There we go. Okay, so this is interesting. I thought it was powered by USB-C. But it appears to be powered by a standard kind of pin power thing that goes in there. So what is the USB-C port for? I wonder. This is a UK plug for all those in America that aren't sure what this design is. UK plug. Let's angle that up a little bit further. Right, so now we go through the setup process. Okay. I like stuff. Okay. Thanks, Facebook. Okay, right. Play and pause. Quite obvious. Let's go for English UK. Find the right place for Portal. So yeah, this is just kind of going over what I said earlier. You can either have it on top or below your TV, depending on your individual setup. Mounting Portal TV. Ah, there's another one at the front. That makes sense. Yeah, there we are. Okay, I missed something earlier. There's a little secondary cover at the front, which allows you to, yeah, there we go. That is a lot more secure than it was. Okay, ignore me. So that's mounted, we're good. There we go. So we're connected to the Wi-Fi, and now we need to go through the setup of the portal itself. Right, is there an update? Of course there's an update. Of course there's an update. So we're just gonna download this and then we'll be back. The download and installation is complete, but now we have to restart. So let's just go ahead and do that. Have we gone to sleep? No, just in time. Okay, we're back on track. Okay, next up is an update for the remote. We'll be back in a minute. Yes, the updates are done. Okay, right, let's get on with this. Let's set up your portal, let's do this. Terms of service, because you know, the best thing to do is not read them and just agree. Give my portal a name. Let's just go with living room for now. Next step is to, somewhat obviously, log into your Facebook account, because that's how this thing works. Log in with Facebook. Okay, so right, what I need to do now is go on my phone, or if you've got a tablet or a computer or whatever, go to that link and then put in that code. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, so I've hit an error. That's nice. So let's, okay, well it worked. I'm not gonna question it, it's there. So here we have my profile picture and we are connected. Let's go. Set your favorite contacts. Let's just, so as you can see, these are people populated from people on Facebook. Let's just skip that for now. Add WhatsApp contacts later. Yep, let's do that later. See how the smart camera works. So it can automatically pan and zoom. I can't really show you that in this studio environment. It's a little bit small in here. So we're gonna get David to do that when we call him in a minute. So not now. Turn off your camera and mute your mics. That's done by shifting the cover on the front. Display your phone's photos. You can do that via the portal app. I don't have that. I don't see the point. So yeah, let's skip that. But if you do want to do it, you just get the portal app, sync your photos with the app, and then they'll appear on the telly. Unlock Alexa on portal. So this is interesting, so that you can use Alexa on the portal TV to control your smart home stuff. We don't actually have anything smart in the office, which is sad. So we'll skip that for now. Continues without Alexa. Yes. Portal is ready to go. Right, explore. So basically what we're going to do now, we're going to drop in on my colleague David, and then we're going to show you what happens when you drop in on someone, this, which is basically the main thing with the Portal TV. So who's using Portal? That's me. Choose from contacts. Right. Is there a way to search? Yep, there's a way to search, okay. David Price, here we are. Add favorite. Now let's drop in. Turn on the camera and mic to start. Cool, press the button on the right hand side of portal. Ah, there we go. So we're dropping in. Come on, David. Hello. Right, hello. This is pretty cool. Right, David, the first thing we want to see is the AR effects of Facebook Portal. Yeah. So that's the same across the Portal TV, the Portal frames, across all Portal devices. But it has to be mentioned that you have to be using a Portal device to actually be able to do it. Oh.
What do you think of this?
That's a very, very hairy.
It's a bit late for Halloween.
We discovered with this that the shape of the moustache, or the colour of the moustache, varies depending on the colour of your actual facial hair. That's very exciting.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Yeah, when I did that, it came off like a dark brown, even though on this video my beard looks a bit ginger. It's not. I swear it's not. So yeah, go on. Oh, that was weird. Try opening your mouth. Oh, I like the transformation with that one. It's pretty cool.
And then if I talk like this, then it should change my voice.
It does change your voice. You sound a lot deeper than normal. We got anything else that stands out? Oh. Just floating head, David.
Here
we go. Oh, this one. You got a voice changer.
Googly eyes.
Googly eyes.
Me is Elvis Presley. What was that one we liked? The cat, wasn't it? The cat.
Yeah, there's a really random one.
That was my favourite one.
There we go. There is literally no purpose to it, but it's amazing. I'm so sold on this. Get up and kind of walk around the room a little bit, because we want to showcase the pan and tilt feature of the tech, which is pretty cool. So this is available across all the Portal devices. That's not just specific to the Portal TV. That's all Portal. You've got the Portal tablets and the Portal TV. So yeah, as you move around the room, as you can see, the camera will follow you or pan in, it will zoom in. And I think that's, yeah, it's pretty cool. And if someone else comes into shot, if someone else comes into the room, like another family member, it will automatically zoom out, so it captures everybody in the frame. And obviously, as David walks around, it will refocus, which I think is pretty cool. Thank you for that. So then, yeah, apart from that, you've got the only other thing that's you've got two things that are memorable. So you've got Watch, which allows us to watch videos between two Portal TVs. So we can't, unfortunately, we can't do that because we've only got one Portal TV. And then the last thing is story time. So this is something for kids. You know, grandparents in one area, the kids are in another. You want them to have that relationship, so you can do story time. So I will be reading. David, you can just enjoy everything. And let's tell a little bit of a story. So once upon a time, there was a tiny, friendly, and very logical spider named Itsy Bitsy. Hello, my name is Itsy Bitsy. I love watching the weather.
This is the story of Llama Llama Red Pajama.
Oh, the animation, that's really cool.
Llama Llama Red Pajama reads a story with his mama. That doesn't rhyme. Mama kisses baby's hair.
Go on.
Mama Llama goes downstairs. Baby Llama wants a drink. Mama's at the kitchen.
Okay, I think we can leave that there, but do you know what? I really like the kind of animations and drawings and stuff like that. It looks really cool. So yeah, thanks for dropping in, and we'll see you later. Bye. Apart from that, you've got a couple of apps on here that run natively. There's not a lot at the moment, but that's something that Facebook says they're going to try and expand over the coming weeks, months, and I assume years. So you've got Red Bull TV, Never Think. Spotify's a cool one, so you can kind of listen to music while you're chilling out. And then obviously you've got Storytime and Facebook Watch. So yeah, it's pretty limited at the moment, but like I say, Facebook's got big plans. So we'll just have to watch this space, really. So that's Facebook Portal TV. Thanks for tuning in. And for more smart home stuff, make sure you check out the TechHive YouTube channel. I really like the panning and zooming of the camera as well. It's really cool. I have no idea what's going on, but I'm here for it.
Lewis, this is rubbish.